lip sync.
I think there were six of us. Just the father was working. Very poor. I mean, yeah, I can remember things. Poor, definitely. Realising money. Money was the thing. I mean, I can't really remember no affection in the family. I'd get persecuted for anything at all that went wrong. I mean, it was ever so crooked and warped, I suppose. A really nasty childhood. Because, yeah, I think, you see, there was a few characters in the family who was spoilt, who were sort of, loved, I suppose. And I was just stood around watching it all happen. And I was the only one, really, this is as I got on to about 6 and 7, who was doing crime. Who was going out and stealing and giving my parents money. It's called creeping, because the general idea is you have to creep out into the back room of the shop, where the cloakroom is, where, like, there might be a little safe, cash tins. You have to creep out there, take whatever you could, and then go again, while the older people are taking up the shop assistant's time. But, yeah, it was exciting at such a young age. That's why I suppose it was so easy, because it was excitement. It was just like on the telly. A little thief. A little bit of respect instantly, even at the people who sort of knew you as a thief. They'd sort of come over all friendly and everything. Instant recognition, I suppose, as soon as someone becomes a thief. Yeah, I got left alone. I got my little peace and quiet. I was tricked into believing it was ever so exciting and great, and you'd grow up to be a big Aardman. And then as I went on, I got arrested again. That was with an older person, another bloke. It was like a 3-month sentence. So it's a short, sharp shock, they say. It was as well. I hated the place I did. I hated the place. It was just so different. You had to be doing something. Like, it was, the authority was very strict, and you was banged away, you was locked in. The offences that followed that then was, I got a 12-month for burglary. And then after that one, they did me for going equipped. You pay the fullest price when you're in prison. I mean, mentally, your mind starts to change. I mean, being in a confined space, a little space, and you know you're in there for months at a time, you really do start to sort of let the mind take over. The mind do get the better of you. People are so easily fooled, I suppose. Because prison, what prison really is, what prison really means, is you could be living with three, like, smelly people. You got to smell their shit. You got to listen to them piss. You got this foul stink in the room. They're all farting. They're all burping and picking. That's what prison is. You got to wait for some 70-year-old man to slop out. And the stink in the morning is disgusting. That's what prison's really about. I mean, people seem to think prison's a generally happy life, when it's a foul, dirty, dirty life. I was guilty virtually all the times. All the times I've been guilty. I mean, that's something I can't deny myself, like. I mean, I suppose even now, like, there's things that's happening. That isn't too honest. That isn't really 100% legit. But it gets me by without doing real crime, without doing crime. I mean, life goes on, as they say. I mean, you have to survive.